75. So this statement will be of two digit number may be three digit number. In this question, let's take the smallest two digit number, that is 10. So by the smallest two digit number is 10. If I will take the cube of this number, then I will get 10 into 10 into 10. Here I will get 1000. The cube of two digit number may be three digit number, but here I am getting four digit number, so this will be false. In the sixth question, it says that the cube of two digit number may have 7 or four digit number. So this was the smallest two digit number. If I can take the greatest two digit number, so by finding greatest two digit number is 99, and its cube will be 970299. The cube of two digit number has 7 or more digits, but here if I can see, I am cubing 99 cube is 970299. Here I am getting 6 digits, so this statement will also be false. 7th question says that the cube of a single digit may be a single digit number if I can take 1. I will cube 1, I will get 1 into 1 into 1. This will be 1. Similarly, if I take 2, 2 cube is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 equal to 8. Or then, by this it is stated the cube of single digit will be a single digit. So this statement will be true. This is question number 3 of exercise 7.2. This question says that you are told that 133 is a perfect cube. 133, it is given that this is a perfect cube. Can you guess without prime factorization? Can you guess without prime factorization what will be the cube root? Similarly, guess the cube root of this numbers. Means a number is given 1331. This is a perfect cube, all of you know, but what we have to do, we have to find the cube root of this number, but without prime factorization. Before this, whenever we were given the question, we have to find out the cube root of this number. What we need to do, we always do that we need to prime factorize the number, and from that we find out the cube root. But here we have to do this number by without prime factorization. For this is very easy. Just follow the step which I am going to do. Make a table of the cubes like 1 cube, 2 cube, 3 cube, 4 cube, 5 cube, 6 cube, 7 cube, 8 cube, 9 cube, and 10 cube. One cube is 1, 2 cube is 8, 3 cube is 27, 4 cube is 64, this is 125, this will be 216, and this will be 343, this is 512, 729, and 1000. This is the cubes of the number. Now, finding out the cube root of this number, see the last digit of this number, that is 1. In this table, see in which cube you are getting 1. So you are getting this in first, you are getting 1. Cube root of 1 is 1 only. So the very first means what you have to do, you have to see the unit digit of this number. From this, it will be very clear that the unit digit of the cube root of 133 will be 1. You got the 1 unit place of this. So similarly, now hide the last three numbers, 5, 2, 3. If I will hide this number, again I will remain with 1. Now what you have to do, you have to check that the cube root of 1 cube and 2 cube. If I will cube 1 cube, I will get 1 only, and 2 cube, I will get 8. So 1 will form between 1 and 2, that is cube of 1 and 1 and 8. So the nearest one will be 1 only. So I will write this as 1. You have to see the nearest 1. So what is the cube of 1331? Cube root of 1331 is 11. This is the answer. Similarly, for the next question also, you need to see the same. 7 in 3 cube is 27. So what will be